we're going to deal with it. Matthew, the 25th chapter. We're going to start at the first verse. Matthew, the 25th chapter, in the first verse. Be patient with me. Sometimes you be messing with these tablets and they'll jump on you. Now I got to get back to where I was. Okay. Matthew, the 25th chapter, starting at the first verse. I'm going to read you. It's going to be just maybe 1 down through 13. I'm trying to read the whole thing. I tried to shortcut, but I'm not going to shortcut on this one. Matthew, the 25th chapter, starting at the first verse, read, "Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took the lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took the lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessel with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, 'Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him.' Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, 'Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out.'" Isn't that something? "But the wise answered, saying, 'Not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves.' And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.'" I want you to get that, okay? You say, "But he answered and said, 'Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour when the Son of Man cometh.'" You may be seated. May God richly bless you. Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer. Most gracious God, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this precious time, Lord, to be able to be here at Old Macedonia Missionary Baptist Church, Lord. We thank you, Lord, Father God, for everyone that, have gathered in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Now, use me, Lord, as you see fit, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Open the ears of your people. Open their minds and open their hearts that they might be receptive unto your holy word. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I want to talk about the danger of being locked out. The danger of being locked out. I'm going to do something very unusual today. I want to see the hands of everybody that has been locked out at some point in their lives. Maybe you got locked out of your car, and when you closed the door, it was just too late. Isn't that right? And maybe you got locked out of your house, and what you needed was on the other side. Isn't that right? You needed your key to get in, right? And before you know it, you say to yourself, "I don't lock myself out, and I cannot get in." Then you begin to get frustrated, and you're trying to figure a way out how to get your keys, because you need your keys, don't you? And if you know in the scripture, Jesus says, I am the key to the kingdom. And I was reading, prayer unlocks the door. You got to have some faith while we are traveling through this world. And I kind of want to reminisce and look back over my life as a younger person. Now I'm 67 years old. I thank God for that. But when my oldest son was a baby, I stopped at the car wash in North Augusta and had the engine running. And lo and behold, while I was washing the engine and washing the car, I left the engine running and he ran over there and locked the door. I was locked out. And of course, when you have a baby in the car, and you don't want the baby, you know, to hurt himself or hurt you. And especially back in those days, I had a 69 Ford Fairlane. The switch, unless you put your foot on the brake in these modern cars, you know, the car, it won't move. But those cars back in those days, all you had to do was pull the gear shift down. And you know I had to be in a mess because I find myself locked out, baby in the car. I needed to get in the car, but I couldn't get in the car because, you know, he had locked the door. Matter of fact, he went to sweating and I got scared and I'm begging the baby, unlock the door. Finally, you know, I, got him to unlock the door, and I was able to get in. But oh, what a sign of release. But I want to say to my brothers and sisters in Christ, and those that may not be in Christ, you don't want to find yourself locked out of the kingdom. Yeah. Isn't that right?
Right.
A lot of folk are going to be locked out. And I'm mighty afraid it may be some of those who you think might be on the Lord's side may not be where they ought to be. And sometimes I'm finding out the more I deal with church folk, I'm finding out that a lot of them, if they don't get their house in order, they're going to find themselves locked out. Huh? You know, we're living in time now where church folk will fall out with you quicker than anybody else. And we're slow to forgive one another. And Jesus said, if we don't forgive one another their trespasses, neither will he forgive us. So we find out not forgiving one another will cause us to be locked out. Isn't that right? Matter of fact, not loving one another will cause you to be locked out. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to be locked out. I'm striving to make heaven my home. You know, I don't believe he brought us this far to leave us. I come too far from where I started from. That's why I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Huh? A lot of folk don't want to even come to the house of the Lord. They're trying to figure out how not to come. Isn't that right? And we say this all the time, don't we, church folk? I see you at Walmart. Can I get a witness in here? I tell my folk all the time, you're putting your meat on, your hands all over that meat at Walmart. You don't know who's touching that meat. You don't know who's touching those canned goods. But when it comes to the law, you're always coming up with excuses. Can I get a witness in here? We're going to find ourselves locked out. We don't get our house in order. Can I get a witness in here? I've known preachers to be locked out of the church. Huh? When they come to the church, because folk don't love them like they ought to love them, they'll change the locks on the door. When they get ready to go in his own office that God has prepared for him, they find out they can't get in their own office. Huh? There's a dangerous thing to be locked out. Isn't that right? Well, I'm going to move on because I don't want to hold you too long. I want to look at our text just a little bit, and then we'll be ready to go. I may drop some other biblical characters in while I'm preaching this particular message. These 10 virgins, all of them, when you look at the text, all of them had the qualification. Isn't that right? Because all of them were virgins. You may look like a Christian sometime, but it don't necessarily mean that you are a Christian. You got to beware of sheep dressed up in wolf clothing. Can I get a witness in here? And I've said this over and over, wolves will hunt all night long. They're even looking in the garbage can. Huh? And it's amazing how folk can pick up the negative that you say and never focus on the positive that you say. Isn't that right? You say something negative and they think they negative, then they'll have a conference meeting on you. Isn't that right? Huh? Because you know, it's a funny thing when the word, you know, go forth, look like it'll find you anyway. It don't make no difference who you are. Be sure, like the Bible says, your sins will find you out. Be not deceived, for God is nothing more. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. Isn't that right? There's nothing covered that won't be uncovered. All things are naked before God. Let's look at our text again here. All of them had the qualifications. All of them were virgins, isn't that right? The Bible said there were five wise and there were five foolish. Isn't that right? The Bible said all of them took their lamps with them. But the five foolish burned up all of their oil. In other words, they did not make any preparation. So you got to make preparation on this side in order to get over on the other side. Isn't that right? And the Bible says the five wise had oil in their vessels. You got to have oil in your vessels. And this particular oil, it was an illuminating oil. It was not just any kind of oil. It was an oil that when they trimmed their lamps and they got burning, it had to illuminate. You got to know which way you're going. You got to let your light shine in this world so men can see your good works and glorify who? The Father which is in heaven. Isn't that right? The Bible said they all went to sleep. It's a dangerous thing to go to sleep, isn't that right? Huh? I remember my baby boy, Quinn, and he was at South Carolina State. And I went down there to pick him up. And on our way back, he had crammed for a test. And on our way back, he was driving. And I never will forget it, I was in my STS Cadillac. And we were coming up the road from Orangeburg. You know, I always like to see where I'm going. I didn't go to sleep. Somebody got to watch. Isn't that right? And while he was driving, I noticed him, he began to nod. I didn't holler, but I said, Quinn. And I nicely took the steering wheel, and I pulled the car back on the right side of the road. But we headed into those trees. Both of us could have got killed. Huh? But I thank God, you got to be careful when you go to sleep. And that's what all of these virgins done. All of them went to sleep. Matter of fact, they slumbered and they slept. Can I get a witness in here? And the Bible says that around midnight, there's some strange thing happen at midnight sometime. Isn't that right? Paul and Silas had a prayer meeting around midnight. Can I get a witness in here? The jail cell shook. around midnight. Every now and then, you ought to talk to the Lord around midnight. Can I get a witness in here? Let me slow down here. We see these bridges now. The knock came. Huh? Everybody answered the call. Huh? The five wise. They trimmed their lamps. They had oil in their vessel. But the five foolish, they had used up all of their oil. Huh? And that's what I mean. Sometimes folk don't prepare. They had used all of their oil up. In the midnight cry, the bridegroom was at the door. There was a knock at the door. Matter of fact, God is knocking right now. But we failed to answer the knock. Because he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man let me come in, I come in and I dine with him. I sup with him and he with me. But you see, you got to unlock the door from the inside. A lot of us don't want him, want him to come in. Isn't that right?
That's right?
You know why folk don't want the Lord to come in? Simply because they don't want to change their ugly ways.
Right.
Huh? Some of us, we're a midnight rider. Some of us still haven't given up the club yet. Especially when your hair gets gray. And you got a limp in your walk. And your top has changed. You ought to give it up. Some folk don't ever want to give up, preacher. They don't want to turn it loose. They want to hold on. Huh? They want to stay young all of their lives. But I stop by to tell you, time will run you down. Can I get a witness in here? Sometime I drop a piece of money. And if it ain't no more than a quarter, I just say, let it stay on down there. I heard Brother Glover and I, we were laughing. He said a white man told him that he dropped a piece of money. He said, son, you can have it if you want to. Look like that ground is getting further and further away. But it was around midnight. Isn't that right? And they, you know what the foolish wanted to do? They wanted the wise to give them some of their all. There are some things you can't give folk. Some things you got to keep for yourself because you just have enough for yourself. Isn't that right? That was the wrong time to share their all. But the five wise say, go where they sell it at. Isn't that right? Where you can buy you some all. See, why folk, you know, are looking for something else. Huh? They're gone. The cry's going to come at midnight. Isn't that right? And the Bible said, while they were gone, the bridegroom came. I can't tell a thing like I used to, cause after I got sick, I can't preach like I want to. Huh? But they were gone. You see, some folk, they're going to be caught in the wrong places.
Amen.
Isn't that right? I used to listen to Joe Tex. And Joe Tex used to say, if walls could talk, if cars could talk, huh? Whole lot of us will be in a bad predicament, isn't that right? Get a witness in here. Around midnight, huh? These five foolish, they came back, isn't that right? Huh? They began to knock on the door. Huh? Let us in. But the door was locked. Can I get a witness in here? You want to get in? But you can't get in. Huh? There's a voice on the other side of the door. The one that you need, Jesus Christ. Say, no man come to the Father but by me. If you come up any other way, good God Almighty. He come up as a thief and a robber. Isn't that right? Good God Almighty. He said, I am the door. Am I right? Can I get a witness in here? And then you hear the voice on the other side saying, depart from me because I know you not. The door had been locked. But as I get ready to come to a close. I just want to say that I know some more biblical characters who were locked out. In those times, God told him to build an ark. Isn't that right? I know it looked like it was foolish. A man building an ark on dry ground. Listen here. But after a while, good God Almighty, God told Noah, it's going to rain. Good God Almighty, the animals had better sense than the human beings had. Because the animals came two by two, clean and unclean, and they went on in the ark. Can I get a witness in here? And the Bible says that God closed the door to the ark. Then he opened up the fountain of the deep. Just imagine water coming up from the earth and water coming down from the sky. The Bible says that those people sat down to eat, but they rose up to play. Am I right about it? The Bible says it rained 40 days and 40 nights. And I'm saying to you, old Macedonia, and visiting friends, if you don't want to be locked out, you better come on in this ark now while you have a chance. Can I get a witness in here? I don't know about you, but I don't want to be locked out. Jesus told Nicodemus, except a man be born of the water and of the Spirit, he won't even see the kingdom of God. Am I right about it? I'm so glad that I have been converted. I'm so glad that I'm saved and sanctified. And I don't care who knows what the Lord has done for me. Because the Lord woke me up this morning. I was closed in my right mind. My heart was still beating. I had the activities on my limb. Can I get a witness in here? I'm so glad that he died for my sins and your sins. I'm so glad that he came in the form of a baby Jesus. Am I right about it? But one day he will lock out. Can I get a witness in here? Because there was no room in the inn. All of the rooms were filled. And I'm wondering, folk want to lock me out. See, we are unusual and peculiar folk. Those who I thought were on my side, I'm finding out they are not on my side. Have you ever walked up on anybody talking about you? Makes you want to get a little vicious sometimes, don't you? Just a Sunday ago, I walked up on somebody talking about me. Have you ever been false accused? And you know that you didn't do what they say? Folk will set you up. They'll lock you out. Isn't that right? I'm getting ready to come to a close now. I didn't mean to hold you too long. But I don't want to be locked out. I learned how to forgive. Won't forgiveness lock you out? Won't sin lock you out? Matter of fact, most folk that have been locked out is because of their sin. Be sure. Even after I got converted, I find myself on a highway of being locked out. We might as well tell the truth. Sometimes we slip. Sometimes. See, we don't want to tell the truth. Huh? We want to play church. Huh? All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. I don't know about you. I thank God for his grace. And I thank God for his mercy.
For joining us today at Old Macedonia Baptist Church. We believe giving is a natural response for believers of Jesus Christ. We receive God's love and grace, and out of an overflow of a grateful heart, we give. We have multiple ways you can give. You can mail or drop off your tithes and offerings to 200 Macedonia Road, North Augusta, South Carolina, 298-60. You can give using the online giving feature on our website at www.oldmacedoniabc.org, or you can download the Givelify app to your mobile device. Search for Old Macedonia Baptist Church in North Augusta, South Carolina, and don't forget to mark it as a favorite. To whom much is given, much is required. God bless.